Good evening. This is Strange Love, and I'm your host, Cami Kaos. Welcome, babies. Good evening, and welcome to Strange Love Live After Hours. We have done two entire days of tech episodes, and I figure that if there's ever been an episode that we deserve to have all After Hours, it's this evening. But we do have to take care of some business. We have to talk to the two lovely ladies that the tech episodes were brought to you by. We've got Audrey Eshray and Selena Deckelman of the Open Source Bridge Conference. So how'd it go?
Okay. We are awake still, which is interesting.
I took a nap today.
Oh, I didn't.
Naps?
No, I didn't.
I'll be honest, I was at the convention center at 6:30 a.m. on Wednesday, which means I was awake at 5:20. I slept until 9 something today for the first time, and I was...
I bet that felt really good.
It was good. Yeah. You two didn't sleep until 9.
No, did not.
I've been up at 5 and then 6, yeah.
Yeah, same with me.
Tomorrow it'll be noon.
Oh, yeah. So... this has really been a big labor of love for you guys. We had you on before the conference, and now we're very incredibly briefly after the conference, and here you are, and it went okay. It didn't go okay. It went amazing, right?
Yeah, it was awesome.
I think so, yeah.
I was there. I saw the
I had goodness. A good time.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So you guys had a good time. It seemed like everyone else had a good time. Did everything run according to plan?
Yeah.
Pretty much,
I think so.
I think the comment that I made was that on Wednesday, I found myself walking around with not a whole lot to do. And I was like, wow, this, I guess we did plan it out okay. Yeah. I'm going to go actually sit in some sessions.
That was the one thing I noticed looking around. A lot of the staff members were kind of twiddling their thumbs. And I don't mean that in a negative way. They were attending sessions. They were checking stuff out. They'd come in and peek at the StrangeLove Lounge. Looking at what's going on, and I was like, oh my gosh, they organized things so effectively and got so many volunteers that they can actually take a couple seconds and enjoy themselves.
Yeah, that was
go
that
volunteers was that helped so much.
Yeah,
can we have a round of applause for the volunteers?
Yeah, and especially to Christy Kohler, who was just amazing,
who organized the volunteers.
Yeah, she was amazing.
Yeah. I should note that every single person involved in the organization and running of the conference was a volunteer.
Yes.
Because it was a volunteer-run conference.
Yes. Yes.
So indeed. Thank you all of you lovely OSB volunteers. It's happening again next year.
Yes.
Yes. And we haven't decided on a date, but it just definitely will avoid June 17th, which was my husband's birthday.
Happy birthday. I only met you briefly when you came to my house to pick up Selena.
But, sorry, Scott.
But happy birthday, Scott. You're a good man. I hope no one else eats any of your chickens.
I think there might be a chicken hiatus going on.
Yeah, no chickens until maybe the fall.
Yeah, but at some point there will be chickens. And when the chickens happen, I hope no one eats them.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. So I heard, and this may have just been a joke, and I don't think it was, that there's a planning meeting on Saturday, which is tomorrow.
No.
That would be a joke.
Yeah, no planning meeting tomorrow.
There may be some getting drunk.
Yeah, yeah, I think we're going to drink a little. Cheers.
Woo! Drink.
Yeah. And.
Oh, I wanted to know, how did the drinking game session go?
Was anyone there?
Anyone here attend the drinking game session?
Will anyone admit to it?
Some people are still in it.
Do we need to have a drinking game at StrangeLove Live tonight? I'd have to make up the rules, but I'm okay with that. It's after hours.
The hacking drinking game?
I heard that it went well.
Every time someone says what? I don't. Well, Dr. Normal brings up Zappa a lot, but I don't really talk about Zappa that much.
Twitter.
Oh, every time we mention Twitter or someone's Twitter name, you have to take a drink.
Oh,
we'll be. And what were your Twitter names?
Selena Marie.
There we go.
Yeah.
And Spinnerin.
And Spinnerin.
She's still tired.
Like I said, I didn't have a nap.
Yeah.
So is there anything that you would do differently or that you will do differently next year?
Probably, I mean, a lot of behind the scenes things, mm-hmm. I think we'll tackle differently. Now that we've done it once, we have an idea, you know, what did work well for us and what didn't, what our organizational style is like. Mm-hmm. That's been a very interesting thing to sort out. And so I think attendees will probably see more goodness, but behind the scenes, we're definitely going to do some cleanup.
Yeah, I mean, we're definitely going to continue with the tracks that we came up with the way that we chose the talks, mm-hmm. And some of the schedule planning that we did. I think that we got a lot of really good feedback today. There was a post-mortem session, mm-hmm. during the end conference, and you know, people were talking about what things worked well, mm-hmm. or didn't for them. And the feedback about the content and the schedule was just so overwhelmingly positive and good. So I'm super happy about that.
Yeah.
I think that less than a year ago when you guys started planning this, everything went so wonderfully, and you filled a big void in the Portland conference community, and everyone that I've talked to has been overwhelmingly positive and pleased and happy, and thank you guys so much for pulling it off.
Thank you.
Thank you. It was funny, we did a session on, you know, so how do you run an open source conference, and today during the unconference, and so Selena and Reed got at the whiteboard and they started charting the progress of, and there's this point of discontinuity that was just labeled panic in the middle. And I think one of the funniest things about working on this event is that there's always a lot going on behind the scenes that, mm-hmm. the attendees don't see, and that's for your own good. And that would include that panic. But
don't want to see how the sausage was made, people.
Yeah, not all of it.
I like sausage. I'd like to continue to have the sausage. I'd like to continue to attend the conference.
So when I say behind the scenes cleanup, I mostly mean less panic.
Yeah.
And less blood? Maybe? Or am I still thinking about the sausage?
Yeah,
it's after hours, people. This is an entire episode of After Hours. This is the most serious that I think we're going to get, all right? Is there anything that you want to tell us about the conference? Is there anything else that you want to point out before I tell you how happy we of StrangeLove Live were to be there? My phrasing is horrible this evening. We were really glad to be there. Thank you so much for having us.
We were really happy to have you there.
For me, one of the best pieces of feedback, or the most rewarding pieces of feedback that I've gotten, is from people who felt like the social interaction was better than anything that they've had at other conferences. That made me so happy to hear that, you know, because I think we put a lot of focus onto the process of open source and how we can enable people to do open source better. And so hearing that made me feel like we'd actually hit where we were targeting.
Yeah, I would say I had the same experience. You know, I had two different people kind of talk about walking around the conference, running into other people, having those people stop them and say, hey, like, what are you working on? You know, what do you do? And both of them said that's just not something that they had experienced at any of the other conferences, whether they were academic or, you know, kind of professional conferences like this. Just never had that happen that same way.
And how did the Hacker Lounge go?
How's the Hacker Lounge going, people?
We got people here this evening. There, during the day, it was kind of slow, but were there a lot of people here on the evenings?
Yes.
Yeah, last night when I was in here, it was full. There were people at every table working on things and talking and solving Drupal problems and getting Identica help on the spot. It just a little of everything.
I saw a note when I came in that Egal fixed someone's blog.
Nice work, Egal.
Thank you, Egal. He fixes a lot of people's stuff, huh?
Yes. Yeah.
All right, and then the last point that I wanted to touch on was, I think it was something that you said in the keynote, one-third, my numbers could be wrong, but one-third of the presenters were women?
Yes.
And I believe it was Emma that I was talking to that said, in general, 12% of open source contributors were women?
Often lower than that.
Often lower, yeah.
I've been drinking martinis. My numbers could be wrong.
But no, it can be a really tiny percentage, depending on the area within open source.
So did you guys seek to include more women in it, or did it just kind of happen that way?
we sought it out.
It was a very, very conscious effort.
Yeah. Yeah. And a lot of effort was put into recruiting people to submit proposals, recruiting people to attend. We constantly like emailing people, talking to them in person, reaching out to contacts that we knew that might know other women, mm-hmm. like outside of our immediate sphere. Mm-hmm. You know, we did a lot of work to make that happen.
I think you guys did a great job. Overall, the whole thing, the big picture, it was absolutely beautiful. And I think everyone here would like to say thank you. I know I would.
All right.
I think we're going to shift gears a little bit, and we're going to have Selena move down a chair.
All right.
Thank you, Audrey. Goodbye. Brian. Hello, Mr. Mad Scientist.
Hello.
I've never had a bona fide mad scientist on my show before.
Never?
Has anyone watched every episode? Am I lying? I don't think so. I like to pretend I'm a mad scientist sometime, but usually it's just drinks that I'm mixing. I don't know if that
qualifies.
Do you
have a laboratory?
I have a basement. It's evil.
Can you refer to it as a laboratory?
I can.
Oh, see?
All right, so I'm the only mad scientist I've ever had on my show before.
Ah, okay.
This is Brian Acker.
Mm-hmm.
Did I say it right?
No.
Acker?
Yes.
Oh, second time. Could be worse. I could have said it wrong several more times. How can we find you on Twitter?
Brian Acker.
Brian Acker on Twitter?
Mm-hmm. Simple like that.
It's easy. I'm Cami Kaos on Twitter. Oh, Twitter! I'm going to need someone to get me a drink. I'll announce what it is that it's supposed to be later when I need it, but...
Hold it. If we keep mentioning our names, do we get free drinks?
I don't know. I'm Cami Kaos on Twitter.
Twitter.
Before we go... I keep saying it's all after hours, but you were one of the speakers at the conference.
Mm-hmm.
Were you crazy mad scientist guy?
Probably.
Because there was one talk that was all devoted to dragons, and there were dragon puppets and dragon pop-ups and dragon, 2D drawings and dragons everywhere. Did you have, like, a mad scientist set up?
Not so much.
No, it was more verbal mad science.
More verbal.
What was your talk entitled, and how did it go?
My talk was on the, I'm one of the original folks who worked on MySQL for about a decade or so.
Mm-hmm.
And so about a year ago, I ended up deciding perhaps we should just fork it and change it and see what we could redo with it if we tried to start it over.
Mm-hmm.
So my talk was all about what we've been doing in the last year of ever since I finally announced everybody, we've decided to start rewriting MySQL. And it was about how we've been changing, interactions with people and community and all the things we'd learned in the last year, 10 years and the stuff we'd screwed up on and trying to really rethink everything we had done and try to find how to make the project go for another 10 years or so.
Mm-hmm.
Cause it'd been, we I think Unireg got right around 97 is when Unireg, which was MySQL previous, became mm-hmm. actually MySQL. And so it's kind of time to go off and do that again.
I have to say, one of the things that I find so refreshing about the open source community in general is it's one of the few software communities where in public,
yes,
you are willing to say, yeah, we screwed something up and then we tried to do this. Most of them, no, it was a bug fix. Or it was this little tiny thing. Or no, we're just, we have to push it out. There's no, we messed it up and now we got to go and fix it and everything's. I find that very refreshing and joyful and happy. And Twitter. Excuse me. And now we're done with the tech episode, and
okay.
We're going to talk about Burning Man. Let's go. What you working on for Burning Man?
So let me see. This year, what we're trying to do is build somewhere between 3,000-4,000 square foot of space out of PVC, sailcloth, and a bunch of tarps, and see if it can handle really strong winds, something like... We're about 190 pieces of rebar that we're going to punch into the playa this year, and about, what is it? We've actually got, we have these things called earth screws that we're going to see if we can, figure out a way to,
What is an earth screw?
An earth screw is really, okay, so playa, Very not so compact. Things get pulled up. Mm-hmm. Bad idea Monday. You know your whole goal is you set up your camp Monday. It needs to be a fortress so you can sit there and watch like everybody else's camps when the storms occur.
Yeah.
You know, like die, blow up across the thing, and you get to sit and drink. So that's the goal. Put your camp together. It gets solid. Watch other people's camps blow away.
And then so, do you let them come and drink with you in your
camp? Of course.
See, there you go.
We always take too much booze.
Good hosts.
Too much booze, too much food. So the idea with the earth screw is the, you know, playa rebar, you get kind of tired like pounding it in, especially if like half your camp's drunk and big hammers and
which
legs
are.
And bad ideas. So the idea was to use earth screws with these long bars that have these little half discus on the bottom of them.
Is it like a tent stake?
Think about something that needs to go about 2 feet into the ground.
Okay.
And so,
like a really big tent stake.
Not really. It's got threads.
Okay.
But the key thing is that you're supposed to get two people and either side of them, and then they're supposed to go around in a circle to do this.
I'm suddenly thinking about biking ships. Continue.
And it's so long. So what we're trying to figure out is we can figure out an air gun and basically take compressors out and to see if we can take these and somehow fire them into the ground. At high speed, because why not? Yes. And not break anybody's wrist.
I'm thinking as long as no one gets broken, it's a really good idea.
It's always a brilliant idea if nobody gets broken.
Yeah, and no one loses an eye.
Yeah, or broken wrist.
Broken wrist, no one loses an eye, and no one puts the compressor earth screwed through their foot.
Yeah, or trips over it and smashes their feet open and playa.
Blood is bad is what we're saying in this particular case.
It's moop. If you see it. It's really bad moop, and then you got to clean it up.
It's no good. So you were there last year?
Yeah.
Were you there for the big end storm?
Oh, God, yeah.
Yeah? How'd that go for you?
That went really well, sitting inside the RV. Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, we were there. We got barely out the gate during the nice big end storm.
All right.
Watched the temple, like, burn from a distance, things like that. Lots of rain.
I'm sorry. I'm a very.
Were you there for the?
I was not.
Oh. Okay.
I just got to hear the wonderful, beautiful stories of shirt caulking and storms from Don P.
Yeah, the storm was pretty bad.
Yeah.
The fact storms were.
Don P. Thank you. I didn't say it enough times. You're right.
Was that his Twitter name?
Don P. Don P. I'm gonna be doing this all night, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, if you guys say the Twitter, it doesn't count. We have the microphones. If you have a microphone, it counts.
That's right.
Oh! This is going to be a problem. My drink is now empty. Mm. We'll discuss that later.
Uh-oh.
Well, it was wonderful to have you on.
Thank you.
It was wonderful to have you on. But I think I'm going to bring my lovely co-host for the evening up. Mm. And we're going to not change gears because it's all after hours now.
All right.
Brian, thank you so much. It was lovely to meet you.
Did we do that fast enough? How was that? It was like magic.
It was. Did you ever notice?
I have noticed.
There's a problem, and I'm not sure if I'm supposed to be calling people's attention
to it. We're being waved at.
I'm going to stop calling people's attention to it. I'm Cami Kaos. This is StrangeLove Live, and this evening I have a beautiful co-host. His name is Brian Westbrook. Brian Rest. How come I can't say your last name? Westbrook.
I can't say it either. That's great. We're off to a really good start here at After Hours. What can I say, right?
Who gave me a show?
Right? What's that?
I said, who gave me a show?
I heard who gave me a shot. And
no
then I'm
one
thinking,
gave me a shot.
Yeah.
And if they did, it would be a bad idea right now. So
right.
Just let's
no shots. Quite yet. No shots, by the way.
I'm just going to.
Oh, look at that. Ooh. Speaking of magic.
The city is beautiful.
Are we watching this? Are we watching this? Do you see what's happening there? Look at that. Look at that.
It's television magic.
Is this a fancy studio? I'd have been more impressed if they both went up at the same time.
Studio in the sky.
Studio in the sky.
I think the problem is that Nate is the operator of the window covers, and he cannot be in two places at one time.
That's a very good thought. Are you guys having a good time? We have a large studio audience.
We do have a large. I don't think that they all knew that they were in store for this.
I don't know.
I'm wondering if they were all like, I need to go and hack. I need to write some code. I need help with my
problem. How many of you are on deadline right now and trying to get some final code out?
And we're being very distracting.
Yeah.
Go work.
Are we distracting you?
No.
Yeah, all right. I mean, don't mind us. We just got a show to do here.
We're going
to
do it anyway. You can tell us that we're distracting. We'll send you in the other room with the big long table by the
bathrooms. Or to get a drink.
Oh, we might.
I mean, yeah.
10 minutes. Yeah.
There you go.
So, Brian.
Yes, I'm.
How was your week in Portland? No, I'm serious.
You don't live here.
Let's get this straight. Brian doesn't live in Portland. He lives in Seattle.
What I really like is everyone that laughed and they have no idea why they laughed. They really don't even know why that was funny.
It's because I said so.
The answer to your question was it's been a long week.
Yeah.
Lot of things going on. I love coming down. I always try to schedule a number of things. And, of course, it was one thing literally right after another this week. It was crazy. It was busy. It was a lot of fun. A lot of open source bridge, a couple of appearances, this, that, and the other. I got to hang out with my beautiful co-host.
You didn't get to hang out. We kidnapped you, and we just stay in the Strange of Life streaming lounge the entire time because we had more fun that way. Because
it was a good time. It was a lot of fun.
And we needed help with our sign.
Your sign?
Well, we didn't bring the sign tonight because, hello, Portland's behind
us.
Oh,
the sign, yeah. So I can actually take credit for the fact that on the second half of day one, it was perfectly laid out.
And not wrinkly.
Hung at the right angle. No wrinkles and weird bows. You know,
I forgot
it's sort of
the
added
stick.
Value. The stick. It was literally a $4.60 stick. Everyone there is like, really? Are you talking about a stick?
We are.
We're talking about a stick. Yeah.
So you're. What are you doing? Stick. What are you in town next?
So
week?
No, actually, I go back on Saturday, and is now a good time to?
Now's a good time.
To break out some news.
Now's a good time.
I feel kind of awkward mentioning this, but
I said he had some, to.
But. Cami sort of forced me to bring it out.
I'm very bossy that way.
Yeah. And by the way, everyone in Seattle is going to be upset that I'm telling Portland first. But starting on Monday, I will be taking what we would like to refer to as a real job, which for me has been about a year and a half now since I've had what we call a real job. It means you will probably see me a little bit less. If you're lucky, you'll see me a little bit less. Mm-hmm. But I will be the new media director for a radio group up in Seattle called Sandusky Radio. And that starts on Monday. So if I seem a little less tweeting Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday,
you did
that
not
may
tell me
why.
It was going to affect the tweeting.
Did you see that I said the word tweet? Oh, it's
hello,
tweet?
Do you see let's a take drink a vote. On my
let's,
table?
Let's take a vote. Well, first of all, I feel like Cami's going to need a beverage in 10 minutes. So we should probably...
Oh, dirt, does she sweet. Know? Morgan, are you down there? Dirty dry Bombay? She it, knows exactly what it is?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Okay. That helps Cami Kaos.
Yeah.
And at some point, I will also need another beverage.
What are you drinking, babe?
Something with vodka.
I can try to get Morgan downstairs.
Okay.
Yeah,
we're
I
on
have,
it. We're going to call the producers and have them. Whatever, she's IMing. There we go. Monday, I lost my train of thought drinking. Oh, Twitter.
Oh, sad. So Twitter. No more Twitter.
There may actually be less Twitter action going on because
Boo.
I may actually be focusing on that job thing. So, anyway, your continued support, as it were.
Congratulations.
Obviously.
I'm so happy for your job. I'm sad that you won't be tweeting.
I'll still tweet every once in a while.
Are you still going to be doing the gadget thing?
Absolutely. Of course.
Can we do some gadget stuff?
We can absolutely do some gadgets. Do you want to do some gadgets now?
Yeah.
Should we do some gadgets now? Anybody want to see some fun gadgets? No.
Yeah.
No.
Gadgets. Who wants to see a fun gadget? Do you have some fun gadgets for me?
I've got a couple of fun gadgets. Let me.
Do
make
you have anything
sure.
I can stick in a vase?
I do, actually, yeah. Let me see what I have.
Does anyone have a vase that I can stick something in?
I'm going to tell the story real quick because I know not everyone watched the episode of StrangeLove Live, which was, I think, actually the second most downloaded episode of StrangeLove Live.
Sure.
I'm making that up, right? Or the second
Dr.
least
Normal,
downloaded.
Do we have any numbers on that?
Yeah. Dr. Normal, can we say, was my episode of StrangeLove Live downloaded at all?
No.
Apparently not.
Dr. Normal doesn't have these.
That would
there I am.
The voice of God has said.
Yeah, that would be enough.
Oh, Lord. This is so much fun.
he doesn't like to deal with Brian and
Chris
I together.
Chris Perillo had you beat. Oh, I'm sorry.
You know,
this is Portland. We want second best.
You know what I like about that, though, is the fact that it took two Seattleites to have the most downloaded episodes. Right? And by the way, anybody that's tweeting this, we're completely bullshitting you right now. We're making this all up. I showed this on the square. This is the Verizon Wireless OLED Alias phone.
This
the one
is
that
not
has
an
the
iPhone.
Right.
I don't know how
to work
it.
Okay, hold on. right. I think Cami, what I'm hearing
there
from Cami
Kaos. There are no letters.
All right, here, let me trade you out. We're done with
this. Oh my God. No, wait. This is so cool because magically, it changes what the keys say. No, seriously, it does change what the keys say.
Hold on. There we go.
See the keys? How it says A, B, C, D, blah, blah, blah. And now look, I push it and it has numbers.
And then it also, if you could, you can also go this way with it.
That's
so that it redraws the screen the other direction. So it's kind of a versatile phone, if you will.
There we go. Okay, now flip it the other way.
And while we have our fabulous close-up camera operator here,
pants.
I want to show everyone. This is the new iPhone 3GS. Now I didn't start the day today thinking I was going to get one of these. And you know, of course, Apple. They're like,
"Hey, dude, you have a compass."
I have a compass. We are currently we have our backs to north.
North. I can't even face you anymore.
And another cool feature is the camera, which is a little boring if we show. Here, let's bring your camera. Follow me here. If we do
go
this
ahead and
with
say it.
Camera gal, you with me? So if we do this and
if you call me gal again, I will punch you out.
Camera babe.
Overheard.
Hey,
yeah.
Hey Kelly. Watch the close-ups of the cleavage while you're doing this.
Okay, yeah, here we go. How about this?
I don't think they're watching the iPhone. Okay. Right
let's
now.
Be fair. Let's be fair. Brian was
so
focusing on the cleavage.
This is the new, and you can all see on your monitors or those watching at home. This is the new iPhone 3GS, and the video mode. We're taking a video, a very steady video, if you will, of Cami there, and we've got Dr. Normal in our control room, and we're recording video. And the nice thing is, when I'm done, I can hit this stop button. And I can go back to the video. I can play the video. And yeah, we don't want the audio
let's
on that.
Turn that volume
but
down.
I can actually select clips here. So you can select a clip and then I can just say, you know, let's delete that part. We can edit out different clips. And then
so
when
it
I'm
has
ready
an editor built in?
When I'm ready, I can actually take this to email the video, I can send to YouTube, or I can cancel. So it's kind of fun. It has the ability to do video, it's got a compass built in. And certainly the ability to edit video is kind of cool. How many is and did anyone else here get an iPhone 3GS or am I the only crazy one? One.
Oh, Audrey.
Audrey's got one.
Woo! She had time.
How do you like
all
it? Where did you get? Where did you get? Oh, she's look at that.
Wow.
She's, literally, I'm looking over and she has the iPhone plugged into iTunes, setting it up right now. That's kind of what the Hacker Lounge is all about, right?
Yeah, it is.
That and tweeting.
Tweeting. I can almost be a part of that.
Holler.
That's
true. That's true. Can your iPhone get you a beer? Yeah.
My iPhone almost got me out of a hallway that I was locked in earlier today.
But your iPhone, I heard your iPhone was having issues.
I'm having problems. I mean, I love my iPhone. I have a first generation iPhone. I don't even have a 3G. I've had it for 18 months now, I think, and I use it constantly. The only problem that I'm having is that my battery is starting to charge down a lot.
So your battery has a hard time lasting? Is that what
I charge it every night when I go to bed, but I found, especially at the end of the conference day, because I was using it a lot, I was bumping up on the red, 10% when it starts
there
to...
There are actually, one thing, for those that have an original iPhone, if you want 3G, you can use this new Verizon Wireless MiFi. Can you guys believe that this is actually a hotspot? They're like, no.
Can I see?
Ooh.
I can't put this in a vase, right? Let me see.
Thank you.
So if I vase this, it's an issue.
Yeah, please don't vase that. Well, you actually could probably picture it. I think get a picture. We don't have a vase
That
here,
is really
but,
cute.
But no, that's actually, Verizon has one, Sprint has one. It's a 3G air card. It works just like the USB devices, battery powered, and it also has Wi-Fi. So you can create a Wi-Fi hotspot anywhere you can get 3G service.
Whatever.
Yeah, whatever.
You know what? Mostly I use mine at home or where I...
But you have an iPhone,
yeah,
and your battery dies.
It's not. I'm not. Well, you
you're not
are,
that cool.
I'm not happy.
But I have a Mophie juice pack,
and it's not just that I'm all pouty because I want a new. I do want a new one, but it's not just because I'm all pouty because I want a new one.
Actually, I have a little secret here. I actually got a new 3GS iPhone for you, Cami, and we haven't even opened.
Oh my God.
If we can.
Yeah,
isn't
when
that
did
awesome?
You find the time to do
Wait
that?
Wait a second. Is this? Did
yeah.
you?
Yeah, I. When in between set, you know.
I mean, I know your one. Schedule's been busy today.
Oh, wow, yeah, you know, like
that's really nice.
Awesome.
Can I have it?
And it's almost Father's Day and everything.
That's so nice. Now
so here we go. I'll just
I'll just give it to her.
Oh,
jeez!
Oh.
Oh my God!
Well, sorry. I'll just get. You don't mind
there,
if it adds a little
there,
bit
just,
of.
Just,
okay.
There, just.
Oh,
oh my God! Oh, guys.
Oh no!
I'm really, Cami. I'm really sorry, but I think.
Is it okay?
I don't. Oh my God. I don't know. Could somebody work on this? Could somebody fix this? By the way, our props department says hello. Well, Cami, maybe
Dr. Normal so did not buy me a new damn phone.
But there's more.
Here's the funny thing. I think we actually had Cami going. She knew something was up, but I think she actually you were actually aww. You know what I think, and I bet we could take a survey of the room and learn that maybe Dr. Normal should actually buy Cami Kaos a new iPhone. What do you think?
I like how he's ignoring you, like he can't hear the mic.
Well, there's another new gadget.
Oh, dear.
One I've hacked myself.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I know nothing about this. I have no idea.
Yeah, this is my own invention, and I think it's only fitting. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to... we're going to work on this here a little bit.
You got a blinky light there.
It's a red blinking light. Wow.
Does that do something?
Face. Try that out. And I'll cut to the... Ladies and gentlemen, is Helmut Cam. Helmut Cam 2.
No, we've already done Helmut Cam. Are there naked pictures of me?
No.
Okay, good. I'll allow it then. No, we had Helmut Cam 1, and it had...
It's sort of working.
This looks all right, don't you think? Don't you think this works? Does this look all right?
Hi.
Yeah. Hi.
How you doing?
I think I'm just going to take this into my job on Monday. Be like, hey, guys, how you doing? Yeah. Never mind the camera on my head.
Cami?
What do you think?
Yeah.
There you go.
Live at 7, Helmut Cam.
All right.
Well, there we go.
How do I look?
Oh, that's a great look. Nice. If there's anyone with a camera or a cell phone.
There we go. Can you look into each other's eyes? Just hold it right there.
Dude, if I bend my head over, then I'm afraid the hat's going to fall off. You have lovely eyes, Brian.
You have a lovely helmet on your head.
Yeah. I do. What number is my helmet?
Your number, well, I don't know, 3 or 33 or 10 or 15. Depends on which side I look at, right?
I'm telling you, next time you're on the square, you're going to be debuting.
I actually do think this would be kind of funny on the square. We should totally do a... really?
Oh,
will you rent it to me?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's fabulous. You know...
Hey, what's going on over there?
I actually think that it might be a good idea, though... Because there are cameras in the studio, maybe we should take the helmet cams and send them out to the crowd.
I think it's a good idea.
And then we should check out. Who needs a helmet cam? Oh, here we go. Absolutely.
Oh, absolutely. Alan, there you go.
And Alan earlier. And lasted.
Don, earlier today, we were wrapping these up, and my mom said, I said, who should we get to wear them? My mom said, do you know a giraffe? And I said, the closest thing I know is Don P. All right, go and
there you go.
Frolic about.
And now keep in mind that if you're wearing these helmet cams, great. And we the Roomba idea got rejected, right? I mean.
I like the Roomba idea, but mostly because it involved us buying a Roomba and then me having it in my house afterwards.
Well, and the Hilton would love that because the Hacker Lounge would have clean carpet.
We wouldn't have to do as much work when we vacated the premises.
I was going to say something there. Thank you, Hilton. Lovely hosts. Thank you.
I don't understand.
No. Okay.
I'm not sure I understand the problem.
There's comments about... The Roomba.
So the good news is we'll be checking in on the helmet cameras later. Dr. Normal has the amazing TriCaster
Have we said hi to Dr. Normal yet? I'm Cami Kaos, and as always, I'm joined by Dr. Normal.
I'd need to switch to my camera.
Oh, do you need a camera for that?
Hey, we may want to go to the Dr. Normal control room camera. So we will give Dr. Normal an opportunity to. We were told to give him a little warning.
I forgot. Actually, I didn't forget so much as I didn't think he wanted to be on camera, so I didn't think it mattered.
Hey, Ken. Yeah. I could use that beverage now.
You can use a beverage? Oh, my God. Ken, go get him a beverage, please.
Yeah.
Oh,
there I am.
He has to deal with me.
What do you want? I'm telling you, the helmet cam. Watch this. What? 2010.
Oh. All right.
It's going to blow up.
There you go.
It's going to be the next Sham Wow.
The next Sham Wow.
You know what? Can I tell you guys a secret? I knew that there was going to be a gadgety time, and I thought that I might want to bring a gadget too.
Is that Morgan's? I think that's Morgan's. That's Morgan's. Yeah, don't give away Morgan's beverage.
No.
Anyway.
Run for a drink, because we'll have you on eventually.
Yeah.
So anyway, I brought my own gadget.
Uh-oh, Cami Kaos has brought a gadget. Does it
vibrate? No, I don't bring those gadgets out. Those stay at home.
Oh. It's a hat. Now,
it's a Strange of Life baseball hat.
Hang on. I have seen a gadget or two in my day, mm-hmm. and that looks a lot like a baseball hat. Oh, but wait. I got the but wait finger.
It's not going to be very impressive, though, because we've all these lights, but.
Oh! I bet if you were to point it right at the camera, it would distort all sorts of settings.
She presently looks like a Jawa.
You and I are going to have words.
Ladies and gentlemen, Nate Angel.
So, yeah, I think this is self-explanatory. It's for, well, no.
Spelunking.
The first time I saw one of these, it had camo. It was a camo hat.
Right.
It's for hunters.
Okay. Do you do a lot of hunting with those headlights?
No, I don't.
And he's spelunking?
By the way,
I don't know why, but spelunking is just one
face?
Of those. A little bit, yeah. A little bit.
No, but I
it's
thought
it's probably hurting
really,
your neck, too.
It is. I thought it'd be really good for reading at bedtime. Shut up, I read.
Seriously?
Seriously? I read books and stuff.
Uh-huh, and stuff. No, I'm not doubting that you read. I'm doubting that would be a practical use of the...
No, oh no, actually, this is really why I got it. Because my book light clips on.
Okay, all right
no,
then,
my
there
book
you
light
go.
Clips on, and when you bend its neck, it tends to blink out a little bit, and I don't like that. So I thought, and then if I fell asleep with that on my head, it wouldn't be a big deal.
Aren't you glad I didn't get you an iPhone?
No.
Oh, okay. No.
Why would I be glad you didn't give me
no.
an iPhone?
No.
I think we want her to wear the hat some more.
What's that?
I think we want her to wear the hat.
Oh, I think we should put the. Should we put the. All right, we're going to ask the audience. Should we have Cami Kaos wear the light emitting diode hat some more? No.
Yeah, it's actually called, for the record.
For the record. Oh, it doesn't match the dress. Sorry.
It is called Panther Vision.
Panther
Vision. Cougar Vision.
Yeah. That was for the live stream. Someone yelled out, "Cougar Vision."
Yes.
Nice.
And I could be a cougar if I wasn't married and happily engaging in sexual acts with my husband.
Thank you.
Yeah.
back and to the show.
I love it. I love it when the other two of us have absolutely nothing to add. And thank you. Well,
that's how I know I'm doing my job. Do we have other guests that we should bring?
Sure hope so. For the sake of our audience, everyone watching on the live stream, and our own sanity, I shall hope we have other guests.
Are you going to talk in an accent?
What are you talking about?
I've got to figure out what order the cards go in, or I'm going to get beaten.
This is great. Do we have a card filing system?
It's not a joke. You really will hit me, and I know it.
When did you get the co-host?
I got him for tonight because I'm tired of talking.
About 10 minutes ago.
I picked him up in the bar.
Sweet. Yeah, I've heard that, right? Yeah, thanks, Nick. Appreciate the love. Yeah, so then you take this chair here.
Yeah.
And then I'll move over here.
You better right, you're moving over there.
And then I get this microphone here that's apparently not even
Jeffro.
On. I can just kind of like, you know.
Hi, well, you're the one Jeffro, with the accent. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty well. I learned well this week.
You learned well this week?
Yeah, you say good, but y'all forced to say well.
What'd you learn well?
You know that
it's not
that old internet community called the Whale?
The Well, I've heard of the Well. Yeah, the Whole Earth Electronic Link.
I was first member of that.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Back in what, 1973 or something?
Something like that.
Yeah. Yep. Back in the day. Yeah.
Yep.
And what's up with the Well, or the Link, as the hipsters like to call it? What's up with that now?
We can't tell you.
Oh.
Hey,
oh.
You know what we forgot to do?
The drink.
I'm getting that. We forgot to introduce Jeffro.
Oh, well, we better do that.
This is Jeffro Hardison.
How y'all doing?
Everyone say hello to Jeffro.
Where can we find you on Twitter?
I am at J.S. Hardison, and I have about 10 other accounts, too. They're all multi-level marketing accounts. J.S. Hardison 1, J.S. Hardison 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
But do me a favor and don't ever reduce those accounts, because that's how I get so many followers.
No problem. The point is, I've got a multinational PR firm behind these accounts, and they're gonna take care of it. You don't have to worry about it.
I have to say something really serious for a moment.
One moment.
My husband's very disappointed in me because I have like 900. How many? I have almost 1,000 followers. I'm like less than 20 under, and he's constantly putting pressure on me to get more followers.
If there is anyone in the room that is not following Cami Kaos,
if you knew my husband, you would know that's
the
truth. He's like, Cami, why don't you have 1,000 followers?
Drink.
And I'm like, I don't know, because I don't. And he says, why don't you just go follow some people?
This
show
will not stop until Cami Kaos has 1,000 followers.
I got to break in here. I got to say, how many people right now are thinking that this looks like old Jim and Tammy Baker?
I do not have on that much makeup.
And replace Twitter with,
Could you do me a favor? Could you do me a favor? Camera guy, are you with me? Could we scroll an 800 number?
Yeah, exactly.
1-800.
I do feel
follow
like
follow Cami on Twitter.
I do feel like we really need to scroll an 800 number.
Have y'all
back to our guest?
Oh yeah, no. That's right.
Can I have a question for y'all?
Jeffro,
have y'all ever watched any Broadcasting Network?
Yeah.
I don't understand you with your strange language.
The woman with the purple hair on Trinity Broadcasting Network.
No.
Have you ever seen this before?
No, I have
She's
not.
Got long hair. Anybody seen this?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
No?
Yeah. Why are you talking?
Well, because it keeps moving.
I need two mics.
Oh, Lord.
I always wondered what would happen if we had you on the show after Ignite. I kind of was like, God, he might be a fun guest, but then I might not be able to control him. So it might be a problem. I know. Yes, it's all about control. Do I need to sing a Janet Jackson song now?
No, put on the hat.
Hat.
Okay,
hat,
you got all hat, control right now,
hat,
okay?
Hat.
I forgot it's West Coast. You got all control, okay? I cede all control. It's yours.
All right, so you spoke at Ignite. I know because it says it on the card and because you spoke at the same Ignite that I did. So I'm aware of these facts.
I did.
What did you want to tell us about that?
Echo chamber. Nothing. Next question.
Hold on. Let me consult the card.
Wow.
What's it like coming to sophisticated Portland from rough and tumble Kentucky?
Wow.
Well, I think I got a lot to bring y'all. I think I got some pragmatism.
This is the same talk you gave at Ignite, right?
No.
Okay, go ahead.
it's part of a campaign, Cami.
Okay.
This guy part is of campaign. Cammy's, it's a Charles Grodin, actually.
This is
if you get that reference.
This is part of a multi-channel campaign. We go live on Ignite. We come here. We tell all the message about how Kentucky's very pragmatic,
mm-hmm.
and
mm-hmm.
that you all invent things. Mm-hmm. And then we take and we make them work.
Like bombs?
Like Twitter?
Oh, you went deep for that. Low blow, Cami.
It could be that I was there, or it could be that I read the card. Or it could be a little bit of both.
Who wrote the card?
Yeah, I did not write the card.
Yeah, so, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Anybody write the card?
Yeah. Okay, well, just move on. It's all right. I just, just wondering.
I heard you also spoke at Backfence about a bomb. Are you concerned about the social media reaction?
Well, the thing is this, is that I've learned what you got to do with people that are trying to be citizen journalists. Basically, you just go on the comment section. You say whatever you want. You just be open, honest, transparent. authentic.
Uh-huh.
You know, and you can even be mean. It doesn't matter because you're being your real self.
I like being mean.
Yeah, you're being your real self. And that's just basically what I've done is I've been monitoring, using other monitoring tools out there,
mm-hmm.
all the negative feedback and the conversation
mm-hmm.
about the talk.
Yeah.
And it's been going on. It's like throwing zingers at people.
But what have they said? I heard the talk. I thought it was good.
Which one? You were both.
Well, you didn't say it was excellent.
No, I guess my point is I thought it was skewed on the better than, like, I wouldn't have been bad about
the
talk.
It was the better than crap side?
Well, no, it was definitely one of the best talks. By the way, I was glued to my seat.
Except for that really? He talked the same
absolutely.
Night that I talked.
I'm not talking about Ananda. I'm talking about the...
Oh, okay.
That got me all weekend talking. No, I mean, honestly, it was a good story. I thought it was
a good story.
And I don't want to know if it's true or not. I'm going to go ahead and believe it is because they told me to believe that the talk, that the background.
They're not supposed to tell untrue stories.
You know what? You know what? I'm really glad you said that because before you said that, because you were staring at her funny, I was going to beat you up. And you said something nice to me, and so we're on the same side now.
Is it because I stared at her funny?
Yep.
Oh, okay. Well,
somebody's got to stand up for a woman.
At some point. One might hope that would be Dr. Normal. I'm just saying.
Yeah, no. That's not a priority.
Yeah, we lost
okay.
Dr. Normal to the TriCaster.
I'm just thrilled at what, you know, making sure that this is a content-free episode.
It's After Hours. And Dr. Normal relies on me to kick the asses of people who stare at me funny myself.
What?
You weren't paying attention to what was being said, so... Just, you know, go about your business.
No, but seriously, this is what I got going on. So I don't really have to worry about too much of taking care of what the conversation is out there in the land. I got a team of people. They're all down in San Francisco. They got those big wool shawl things they put around here to stay warm, and they hold their coffee cup like this. And then they say interesting things like, I know. You know.
Oh, the experts.
I know.
Experts.
Yeah, yeah, experts.
Gurus, mavericks.
Yeah, yeah, mavericks. Drink.
Yeah.
No one said Twitter.
Well, here we go, Twitter.
I've learned I need to take tiny sips.
It's all right. We don't know what it is, but
don't matter. I'm just looking at a little peanut gallery.
Looking
over here.
At me funny.
I ain't looking at you
all
funny.
Drinking, giggling, having a good time. All right, sure. Define on air.
This Walking is not on air. We have a captive audience.
We do have a captive audience. What I like is that we can't keep the audience in this room captive.
But they're not running away. Why aren't you running away?
So I'm going to ask y'all a question.
Hey, here's a question.
Can I ask you all some questions?
Yeah.
Okay, these are Tweetiquette questions.
Tweetiquette? Tweetiquette?
Tweet as in Twitter?
It's like Twitter meets etiquette.
Twitter meets etiquette, okay.
All right. How much are you allowed to retweet something positive somebody says about you?
Once.
Okay.
Never. Really?
All right. How often?
There goes my tweets.
How often can you? Oh.
Wait.
How often
Jeff
can
Bro
you?
Has the floor.
I got the floor. How often can you overhear something you're thinking?
It depends.
I do that like twice a day at least.
It depends.
Our house, we pretend that we overheard it and we go ahead and tweet it. But I've heard the rules are that you have to hear someone say it and they can't be talking to you.
Okay. I got another question.
What if you say it? Can you overhear yourself saying it?
I've only done that like. Three times.
Yeah, three times. Okay, all right.
But it was really clever.
Jeff has another question. These are good questions.
I got another question. So, you know how sometimes people get upset about people not following back when they fall down?
No.
Like, say you follow somebody, they didn't follow you back, and you get your feelings hurt a little bit.
I'm kind of okay with that, but I know somebody that refuses to follow anyone that does not follow them.
Now, can you explain their methodologies?
No, because I don't understand it.
Okay.
All right, so the question.
So the question is this. If someone follows you
uh-huh.
and you don't follow them back,
uh-huh.
and then you get vocally upset and publicly upset about people not following you,
uh-huh.
is that hypocrisy?
No.
How do you square that, as the journalists say?
I'm lying.
You're lying, okay.
No, really, if you are verbally... you square it this way. Because you're not interested in them, they are allowed to have their own perspective.
Yeah.
But you can't get upset about people not following you back, but you can choose not to follow people who don't follow you back. I choose to follow people I am interested in their tweets. If they're not interested in mine, because I kind of ramble on a little, that's their choice.
Yeah.
So what do you think about, so a lot of the promise of Twitter has been, and social media in general, is basically kind of undermining and overthrowing the patriarchal notion of traditional marketing and it being all about self-promotion. What do you think about when people combine the personal and the self-promotional in a slick new way like this? Like, let me give you an example here, okay? Give you an example.
All right, I'm listening.
Someone count the characters.
I am so nervous that I have nervous diarrhea about being on StrangeLove Live tonight, where we're going to talk about my new project that's going to rock, and you don't even know what it is because you're going to have to wait and hear about it tomorrow.
I think that was more than 140 characters is what I think.
I would also like to say that's going to make the promo real.
I think it is.
But it's, you know, it's a little combination of personal, a little combination of promotional together in one tweet, and it doesn't look like traditional marketing.
It was actually really just one
because it's really me expressing my fears.
You know, I don't like to follow people that are just marketing shit. I like to follow people who put the personal stuff in there.
Yeah.
So if you
even
want
if it's
me
just subtly promotional, but it looks like personal.
Exactly. You have to have the personal. More diarrhea, less spam. Thank you, Nate.
Now, we can overheard that, right? That's all right?
Well, it was shouted. I think we can. Because we don't know who he was shouting it to.
More diarrhea, less spam.
Let's have a vote. There you go. Who thinks that because Nate shouted something from the audience, we can overhear that?
Yes.
Yeah, and who says, no, we can't overhear that?
Stop talking about it and just tweet it.
I can't. Yeah, I had to put the airplane setting on my phone.
And how many people have already tweeted that now? Yeah. There we go. See?
Nate, you cannot overhear it because you said it.
Overtweet it? What, like via Twitter?
Somebody needs to invent the overtweet.
Overtweet. Yeah, that would be me, overtweet it.
All right,
yeah.
Jeffro, do you have anything else to tell us? I just like saying Jeffro.
I just want to say thank you very much for having me on here. It's been a true honor. It's taken you a long time to have me on here. But
you could totally
I
have
understand.
Your own episode with us.
Could I?
Yeah.
That's a really good idea.
You could.
Could I come on and just do this?
Yeah.
All right.
But it'd be the time that I talked in Southern accent on that, too. It'd be Southern accent.
We both talk like this.
Yeah. It's all about the Southern accent.
Yeah, we talk like this. Dr. Norman, can we do that? Can we have an episode where I talk like this the whole time with Jeffro?
I'm all for it.
Yeah, but here's what I think. If Cami Kaos gets to talk like that, then what's Dr. Norman going to talk like?
Dr. Norman doesn't have Southern accent because he didn't grow up in Texas.
Yeah. I think it might be that time.
All right, Jeffro, bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you, Jeff. Jeff Hardison.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Norman.
Bye-bye.
We like Google.
We have a Frisbee.
If we had sponsors, this would be what we'd be doing right now. We'd be like, and thank you to our
He
sponsors.
Threw his card on the floor like he doesn't need it.
Who is what? Who what? Who what? So our next guest.
No, he's not our next guest. He's our current guest.
Oh, technicalities.
Do not say what.
Oh, I don't need the card. I know
it's,
it. I memorized
it. It's not for
this.
You.
Yeah, yeah. Cami gets the card. Oh, Cami gets the card.
I get the card.
I was just told not to say something, but I don't know what I'm not supposed to say.
I don't know what you're supposed to not say. It's about love.
8 minutes, no talking.
Oh, right.
Our next guest.
I just got told.
Yes. The question is, can Brian be quiet for 8 consecutive minutes?
Okay, go.
No, he cannot.
See?
He can't. It's true.
That wasn't even 0.8 seconds.
Ken, okay, everybody stop the fighting.
Ken, please pronounce your last name for me.
My last name's sorry, I can't do that.
If you talk like Jeff Hardison, I'm going to kick your ass.
All right. My last name is Kiter.
That was
Kiter.
Kiter,
yeah.
All right, thank
I'm
you.
Here on Strange Love Live. Very happy to be here, by the way. Cami.
How you doing?
I'm great. This is the first time I've seen the show and been on it simultaneously or any time. So it's nice. It's really nice.
It's good timing.
It's a good episode to be on.
Because exactly. If you'd seen it before, you might not have wanted to be on it.
Clearly.
To be fair.
I'm sorry. I didn't say that. I don't do any special accents. I actually do a really nice Australian accent.
Good.
You know, maybe the dingo ate your baby, something like that.
See, we just had an Aussie on the show very recently.
I was just
going to
say,
impressive.
Wait a minute, careful.
Oh,
Eric is in the chat room. So.
Hi, Eric.
Okay,
hi,
Eric.
So somebody off camera actually just asked me what I'm drinking. I'm drinking a quad shot screwdriver right now, and that would be my that would be my second drink. I came on, you know how everybody was coming on earlier with their mojitos?
Yeah.
While they were drinking their mojitos, I was off getting my second drink, and I got my mojito at the same time as them. So if you do the math, I have a little bit of stage fright. Yeah.
Yeah. You had to a quad shot, really?
This is a quad shot.
I'm amazed at how orange it is for a quad shot.
I have no idea what they put in it, but I'm afraid of that orange juice. Shot.
Yeah, I'm a little scared of the orange juice. Yeah, but my gin is green, so it's okay.
Radioactivity. Yeah. It's a beautiful thing. So how are you doing tonight?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm wonderful. I just figured I'd be cordial about this whole thing, you know?
Cordial and sweaty.
Am I?
You don't look sweaty. You're acting sweaty.
I'm feeling sweaty.
He did actually tweet to all of his friends and say that he was going to be on the show, that she should check it out.
Yeah.
Look, it's Ken.
Oh, my gosh.
Wave to all your friends.
So what is look rumor right or what right is there. The rumor? Are we missing a letter or what is
no,
rumor?
Because
it's a capital R, so I assume it's proper.
What is rumor? No, it's perfect. Rumor, actually, I've been, you know, we're being geeky tonight, a little bit after hours geekiness, and rumor is... This protocol that I've designed.
Wait. What? I'm sorry. My 8 minutes is up now.
Did she really want you to be quiet for 8 minutes?
You created.
Say that one more time. You created.
Okay, sorry. Because we have the microphones. You created a protocol.
I did create a protocol.
That's all I got.
Designed this. I know, right? I have designed a protocol that is actually very similar to two protocols released by both Google and Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
And the protocol is designed, it's a message queuing protocol, and it's designed to allow large groups of distributed systems talk together. Mm-hmm. And essentially, the cool thing about it is that I've also developed this routing software for it. And long story short, I've developed some weird stuff. Long story short, it ends up being twice the speed of Google's protocol buffers or Facebook's Thrift, which are the two, you know, projects that they've released. And so I'm very excited about this. I'm working on a new company, and that's going to be one of our technologies. And we're going to release the protocol next month.
So, Ken,
I've
known you for a while now, and you created a protocol, and you're building a new company to launch this protocol.
And it's not the protocol, but it's the part.
That is actually the geekiest thing I've heard all day.
No.
Cami, you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you. Well, yeah.
I'm thinking so.
Yeah.
I make up for it by
ladies and gentlemen,
cute.
Ken Kiter.
Thank you.
In case you didn't hear, he says he makes up for his geekiness by being cute.
Yeah, I try
it's
to be
true.
Charming.
He's
I
adorable.
Have this little smile, dimples. It's nice.
Aww.
And I have Wi-Fi in my ass, apparently.
Yeah.
But that was...
That's a painful place to put it.
Yeah.
Oh,
that was nice. Wi-Fi.
Is that
thank
Wi-Fi?
You, Alex.
Yeah.
I'm getting 5 bars from
you. Oh, good. Okay. We got 5 bars from me right now.
You give good
bars.
Signal, baby.
Yeah, exactly. It's one of those clear hotspots, actually. It's quite nice. Doesn't feel great, but, you know, that's the price you pay for high speed.
Okay.
Always. So,
I think we just got in trouble with Kelly.
Did we?
Whoa.
Are we in trouble with Kelly?
Is our senior producer getting upset with us? What?
What?
Us?
What?
No.
Just me.
I think Brian has gotten the evil death glare.
That's why I'm not looking over that.
But
that's,
this.
That's not it, why I'm. That's
but
why I'm not looking
at it.
This
is about Ken.
Oh no, it's not. It's not about me. It's about
everybody here. What do you do when you're not inventing protocols?
Yeah,
that's what I want to know.
I really don't sleep.
Actually, I'm kind of scared to ask.
Oh yeah, I know. Well, it's you. I know you expect it to be something like bungee jumping or like skydiving.
I don't like bungee jumping.
Dangerous. Yeah. No, me neither. There's a lot of. Cable involved.
There's a lot of potential death involved.
Yeah, that whole thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't sleep a lot. So what I usually do is, I like graphic design. I like to drink occasionally.
How's that quad shot treating you, Twitter? Oh, do you have a Twitter?
Twitter.
Twitter. Yeah.
I have a Twitter account.
Who are you on Twitter?
I'm Ken Kiter on Twitter. I know it's creative.
Ken Kiter on
Ken
Twitter,
Kiter
ladies
on
and
Twitter.
Gentlemen.
And it's that's K-E-I-T-E-R as opposed to K-I-T-E-R.
So it's at K-E-N-K-E-I-T-E-R.
Did you say at?
At.
Oh, I guess I did. Uh-oh.
Tasty.
And with every sip, I get a little bit more open to the conversation. Yes,
go.
Feeling good right now.
Your card has words where they don't belong.
She said, comma, throwing it.
Points.
Dave Letterman does a better job of throwing the cards.
Points for the grammatical reference there. That was good.
Well, I like to insert commas.
Micro open source. The card's too far for me to read the rest of it.
Okay, well, I'm actually, I do have one little tiny itty bitty announcement.
Announcement!
I developed this little tiny wiki add-in, basically. It's an app for Django applications or Django projects, and you can just drop it in and go, and it allows you to create an app that documents, or a wiki that documents your app in your app. And then you can export it as a markdown file, which is awesome.
There's a lot of use of the word app here. So in your app, you're able to create a wiki that documents your app?
Yeah, exactly. It's app wiki app.
I said it right, and I still am not even sure.
If you could say that three times fast, though, I would appreciate it.
App, wiki, app. App, wiki, app.
App, wiki, app.
There we go.
Okay.
That wasn't as fast as I wanted.
There you go.
Yeah, I'm not going to say it any faster because then it will come out. Like when I tried to say Brian Westbrook earlier, and it was
What was that you said?
Brian BMW works.
BMW, yeah.
Yeah, I'd stumble over that too.
Somewhere the BMW grave is experiencing magnificent rotational torque.
That's such a cute way of saying that. I like that.
Thank you. Yeah.
But the best part is it went right over my head.
You don't understand? Rolling over in your grave?
Yeah. Oh, got it. The BMW. Okay, got it.
It's nice. It's nice.
Stay with us, camera guy.
The problem is I don't think I actually heard the whole phrase, so I was...
Excuses.
Okay, whatever.
Nice.
Are you getting comfortable?
I'm very comfortable.
Are you feeling good?
I'm
just
feeling
in
great.
Time for you to get booted off the show.
Oh, it's harsh. I love it.
I love that you always know where I'm going, sweetie. Hey, Ken, it was lovely to have you.
Ken, will you do me a favor?
I will do.
Will you take that card to our card?
Can you give her these two? Yeah. Oh, look. Yeah. Now we've turned into our runner.
So,
hey, Ken, thank you so much.
I want to actually, if I could bring up a prop for our next guest.
Ooh.
Because I'm that good. Ignoring you.
There's a cat fight in my show. No cat fights in my show. Seriously, I will be cat fight person. I don't. Not we do. I can throw a punch. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I thought we were mocking me from when I got sensitive. In our home studio, we do have a cat fight sound effect, I'm sure, but we don't have it here.
I can throw a punch?
I know, but I tried to headbutt you once, so there's no telling.
Really?
It's not that I tried to headbutt her so much as that I headbutted her once.
I swear it's time for you to introduce our next guest.
I don't have a card to introduce. Do you know something I don't? Because I thought, are we having who I think we're having or who he thinks we're having? I think we're having who I think we're having. I think we're having Alan.
Yes, we are.
Do you think we're having Alan? Okay.
That was my guess.
All right.
And I was not, you know.
You can just give it to me because I need it because I don't know you.
Oh, okay. So I come on now?
Yeah. You have your hands full.
So hold on 1 second. Well, one second. I got to pull up this proper.
Hi, my name's Alan. Here's my card.
Thank you, Alan. Your card is larger than a standard business card. How did that come about?
Because I'm French.
Oh, and so French people have big business cards?
Among other things.
Ladies and gentlemen, Alan Block.
Thank you. Thank you all. How's it going?
It's good. I was just going to tell them how to find you on Twitter because it's hard.
Oh!
Because it's hard. It's difficult. He's Alan Block on Twitter, but not like building, like CH.
Right. And the first part is actually more
like A-L-A-I-N-B-L-O-C-H.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, that's so, a really sweet picture. Look at
the
that.
The prop that I was pulling up, and maybe for this, I don't know if it's going to stay on here.
That's awesome.
We need a camera.
That's a pretty epic shot.
Can you be with us, camera guy? Let's put it.
I don't know if we can actually. I don't know if anyone can see this or if there's too much glare, but.
Can we do this?
This was from earlier tonight. I captured this picture of Alan taking a picture of Alan.
Before Will Wheaton and Will Wheaton were separated from at birth because we're kind of like a conjoined twin. Sort of. Don't we? We have like the same scruffy beard. I swear to God, he's my long lost.
That's so sweet.
What do you say? And here, actually, this is really weird, right? Here's the actual shot.
So this is the shot.
So this is the camera. That's really meta right there. That's
all right. There we go.
Not John Meta, ladies and gentlemen. Just meta.
Not John Meta. Should I talk into this?
You have a microphone. If you come over here.
Okay, over here.
Oh, you don't even have to. Yeah. There
you go. Thank you. I know. Wasn't that great? That's Will Wheaton. I think I've like. I got a plus 20 to my geek score. Attribute.
I want to say. I want to say you actually told him that too.
Yes.
Yeah, I did
actually say that, and he was like, "Oh, anyway. Sure, no problem." You know.
Anyway, that was,
he knows.
That was just a little extra we had to throw in there.
He's been known to also bless 20-sided die. Just to let you know. So catch
he
that.
He blessed your 20-sided die.
No, he would. He would. Oh, okay. He's done it before.
I missed something.
He's a real, you know. D&D. What?
We're not here to talk about D&D, Alan.
Okay. But yes, we're not going to talk about that.
Open web games.
Right.
Started as a bar camp session. Was this the last bar camp?
So the last time I was on the show was at bar camp.
We only seem to get you on the show when there's an
alcohol
event.
Involved.
Alcohol? No, there's alcohol involved in my basement.
Oh wait, yes, of course.
Sometimes you'll just have to come down to my basement. You'll get the whole 90 minutes to yourself.
Will there be alcohol there? Maybe.
Me? Hello? Yes. Yes, there will.
Gosh. Going to the StrangeLove dungeon.
Do you like tiki drinks?
What?
Do you like tiki drinks?
Oh, of course.
Yeah, because I make a mean tiki drink.
You make it tiki drinks with like the little umbrellas in them and everything?
Yeah. Rum, juice,
how could I
umbrellas,
turn that down?
Pineapple, strawberries.
Yeah.
Little skewer. Has anyone here had one of my tiki drinks?
Tequilas.
Yes.
Tequilas.
How are they?
Tequilas.
Fabulous, actually.
Is it with tequila?
Actually,
no, good. Rum. Well,
rum. Oh, rum. Okay. So kind of.
I do make mean margaritas, though. So I would be willing to, you know.
I've been on a tequila. Anyways, open web games.
Yes.
So
let's be on target.
So I had been drinking, and then
like you do.
Yeah, and and I was like, you know, what would be a great idea for the open sessions is to like. Talk about games, you know, because I didn't see any of that, and that's always the thing that I really like to talk about and geek out on. So there was a session on non-Flash games, mm-hmm. right? I think I said that at the last show. And so a bunch of people showed up, and we had a Google group, and we've been geeking out on that and, like, passing links, and we're like, all right, okay, open source bridge. We're going to, like, have, like, a little session and try to get something going, right? So last night at the Hacker Lounge, you know, bleary-eyed.
Oh, here.
Yes.
Yeah.
Here.
This would
in
be the
fact,
Hacker Lounge.
This is the Hacker Lounge. Woo! The Hacker Lounge. which is really surprising that we got anything done, right? You know?
I think it's because last night
it was more,
now,
it was really the lounge part, emphasis on the lounge, the hacking thing. It was more like, yeah, we could do stuff, but, you know, whatever.
We could chill.
Yeah. It was like it wasn't the hacker code sprint for sure. Yeah, Twitter. There's
always Twitter bomb.
So
could you do that again?
Yeah, this part.
That was an oh, Alan's drink is empty.
Yeah,
party foul.
That was
by the way, Cami and I get in trouble when we do that on the show.
Oh, whoops. There's a little.
No,
little
you're
annoying.
The guest. You're allowed
you're not,
to.
You're not Cami, and you're not answer. Yeah.
Is that some gin right there? Never mind. Okay, so what is this? Oh, that's good.
I'm really
glad somebody's keeping
bombs.
Us on track.
So,
nice.
Open web games. So last night, you know, we discovered several libraries that we wanted to explore, and mainly what we wanted to do was explore HTML5, which I'll geek out by saying it's
decode
like,
for me, please.
Okay, so it's the new HTML standard that's being pushed out and being adopted by all the browsers now.
Okay.
And it has a lot of interesting new elements to it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, now that they have just an element for video. So instead of, like, having to drop in, like, some weird Flash object, right, you could just have, like, a video tag points to a source, and it automatically renders that video to you. That they have audio tags as well. So, mm-hmm. you know, Dietrich, yeah? Who is Ayala, and I think his what's his handle? I don't know.
Dietrich.
Is it Dietrich?
Yeah.
At Dietrich on Twitter.
On Twitter.
Wait, Alan, you're empty. Hold on.
Okay, pass it on. So, Dietrich, he suggested, hey, you know what we could do. Because he's involved in the Mozilla community and he's really, really excited about HTML5. He says we can use what's called the canvas tag. And the canvas tag basically is this element that you can render bitmap images to. And it has a lot of tools that you can access through JavaScript in order to like make those images on there and manipulate them. Mm-hmm. And so he was showing me all sorts of cool stuff. And we found out, like, hey, you know, actually with some JavaScript magic and stuff like that, we can actually make games with it without resorting to Flash or some, like, hacked JavaScript thing where we're removing, like, div elements around. We can actually be, you know, we have our canvas and we can push stuff out to it. So we're, you know, we're like, yeah, this is cool because, you know, it's non-proprietary, first mm-hmm. of all. That was really big thing that we wanted to get out of it. It's like, it's non-proprietary, it's going to be ubiquitous across all platforms. I mean, that's what, when we say open web, you know, that's what we want, open web games. So we said last night, we're thinking, what should we do? And so we figured, well, why not start with like old school, right? And we'll make Pong. Right?
Pong.
Ah, Pong, right? You know, Pong, it's like the first, it was the first Atari game, yeah, I think, ever made. It's like the Hello World of games, right?
Yeah.
You know, why not that be the first project to work on, right? So we sat there, and we actually had a couple libraries, and so we had this little bit of a code-off between me and this other member, Dean, who works over at /7Games. They did SOCOM, and he was working with this other library. And we're like, all right, who can build Pong the fastest? And I'm like, all right, I got my little Pong ball going. He's like, whoa, well, that's a circle. I have a square. That's more old school. Oh. So we kept on going at that till the late night, and we actually came up with some cool stuff. We so actually,
I think we're going to need a
there's
close-up
a demo.
Cam.
There is a demo. There's a demo. Look at this.
If we could get our studio cam over here, we could take a look at the demo.
Studio cam. Or the maybe. Helmet cam.
Maybe. Or we could bring a helmet cam over here.
I don't know
here.
That the helmet cam won't do it
yeah.
justice.
Yeah, our current we can studio cam.
Zoom in. You can zoom in on the goodness.
Oh, here
we go.
Hold on. We're
so here
how
we
long
go.
Until you can give me some have? circus?
Here we go. We got the Pong going on.
Oh, we got double helmet cam. Okay. Come on, boys.
We got the left side going on right here. We got the Wizzy. Oh, bam. Look, I got that. So this is not real. I mean, it's more just two things, but you know, it's enough, you know, no one wins or loses.
Now did you win the race? Did you
win?
I think so. I think I was the first one to actually, you know, commit something. So, and it was simple enough, which is what everyone was really happy about. But you know, I decided to like just take it to another level, you know, uh-huh. And I was thinking like, well, you know, that's sort of boring. Why don't we do
oh my god.
Since you couldn't get Will Wheaton on the show.
Oh,
I figured
nice.
we get Cami and Doc Normal on there.
We definitely need this.
Yep,
can I
there we go.
Can we just put it on my
that.
Camera?
So you can just, you know, interview him like this, you know.
Nice.
Bang, bang, bang.
So
we're amazing. Wow. We're amazed. We're being amazed by it.
And
we
then,
need to hold on a second. Dr. Norm is going to come over here with the studio cam so that we can
you guys
take
can
a good
try
look at
to
this.
Play it if you want. I don't know if you, it's we got this side. I don't think the collision detection is working, but it looks pretty.
It does. It looks pretty
awesome.
And sweet and beautiful. What's the picture of Will? Let me see.
Oh, it's one of his like little O faces that he does in the Star Trek. He's like, you know.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Don. So this is Pong, StrangeLove Live.
And then we have the other one up here. Oh,
with Will Wheaton.
With the Will Wheaton. And then I have another personal favorite. It's the Ninjas versus Pirates one. There we go here. They got the little... See, and it makes sense, right? Because the ninjas can go really quick with the mouse here.
And like, the pirate is drunk on rum and cannot move as quickly.
Yar, I'm so slow. Shooting around the cannonball. But anyway, so...
Can we see awesome. The StrangeLove one again?
Oh, we're just Alan, can we see the StrangeLove one?
Dom? We'll get Dom back over here with the...
We want to see the StrangeLove live one. Demo.
And the Will Wheaton.
StrangeLove Pong. Oh, yes. Because Will Wheaton couldn't be on the show tonight. We decided to just knock him around.
Will, come back to us.
Oh, wait. There we go. And then I got
to be fair, I had to ask Dr. Normal earlier this evening
versus Normal.
Whether Will Wheaton was most recently on Star Trek or Stand By Me, because I was not well-versed on that information.
He's everywhere, right? He's all part of our childhoods, I think.
That's awesome.
Yes.
All right.
That's pretty impressive.
Alan, that is beautiful.
So anyways,
Alan,
yes,
thank you.
That was beautiful.
So we just got this done. It just took like about 4 hours to do or something.
Only
so
4 hours.
So so that was 4 hours. I'd like to see what he can do with 40.
Yeah, right. Well, we there's so much more cool stuff that you can do with HTML5. I mean, you can even, you know, start rendering video to the browser and like mm-hmm. do you can do chroma key stuff and have a green screen, you know, so you can even do StrangeLove Live
normal?
With like, you know, Star Trek going on in the background. You can have like Will Wheaton saying something stupid. I don't know.
Because he's not here.
No, he's not stupid. He's a very smart guy.
Because just saying something here. That kids
yeah.
would say.
Yeah. He's our hero. So there's a lot of areas where we're thinking of exploring this, and we want to, like, you know, create tools that we can really just, you know, make some really kick-ass games, you know, and just put them up there and not have to worry about platforms and all these other issues. There's this really cool library that actually, there's a language called Processing, which is some Java stuff, and there's really cool images, and there's
processing!
Stuff that can
processing.org.
Do... Yes, processing.org. And now
processing.org?
Yeah. Check out also processing.js. John Rezig did some cool stuff with it anyways. So that's just, that's where an open web games. You guys should, if you're interested in games,
want to
get into development.
What's the website for open web games?
It's a Google group. So, you know, open web games.
So we
Google.
Can find you on, because I feel like it's been a little while, Twitter.
Yes, and we're bumping up against the end of our show, and I'm wondering... where our floor producer is, because I think we might have to have one more person on. But where can we find you online? Because we know you're Alan Block on Twitter.
I'm everywhere. I sort of have
a
placeholder site. It's Ruby Miner. Yeah, it's fun. It's basically just a splash page right now. I'm pretty busy with freelance work, so as far as my internet omnipresence is concerned, you know, I'm more like lurking in the social networks deep in there, kind of doing my thing, and of course coming out to all the cool, you know,
that have beer
face-to-face things
like StrangeLove Live, for
yeah,
instance,
like StrangeLove
right?
Live.
And Will Wheaton appearances at the Square, for
yeah,
example.
Yeah,
so
you
we
know
saw
where
the
to
picture
catch
there.
Me.
That's the
absolutely.
Only thing I've ever seen you at that didn't have alcohol.
Right. I mean,
wait,
it was only because it was so short a time. You know?
Didn't?
I didn't see any alcohol.
There might have been
there.
Alcohol involved to get there.
To be fair, I did see you at Beer and Blog before I saw you at the Square. So
yeah.
All right, well, thank you so much for joining
and remember,
us.
Don't drink and code.
Don't drink and code, ladies and gentlemen.
Don't drink and code. Woo!
My heart cannot take that kind of shit.
All right, Alan, thanks for joining us.
Thank
Give it up
guys.
For Alan, would we? Open web games.
They threw a bunch of Google Frisbees at us.
They sure did. But, you know, I feel like I learned a little too much.
Was
that
too educational?
That was quite interesting. That was very interesting. I just thought so. Uh-oh.
Oh, yes. Take your empty glass. Go sign my...
Oh, and this is yours too, right?
Take another one. No, one more.
Don't forget to take your camera.
Yeah. Go sign the board, Alan.
And now...
I have to ask the floor manager an important question.
Final.
How many more cards do you have in that? Because we're...
Bumping up. Yeah, we talked about it. Yep.
Okay.
Pull up a chair. All right. Have a chat. Hey.
Shall we? Shall we chat?
Jay Rasmussen.
Jay Raps.
Did I say it right?
Yep.
All right.
You did.
Because I've said that name before, and if I had said it incorrectly, I would be a little bit upset with myself. And
kind of entertaining is that people on the East Coast have a tendency to say Jay Rasmussen.
I've got to make an announcement before we go any further. Jay needs a ride home.
Oh.
Where are you going? Where are you going?
So where are you going?
Southeast side of Beaverton.
Is there anyone
southeast
going to the
Beaverton.
Southeast side of Beaverton?
Kind of
southeast
like
side
Tiger
of Beaverton.
Anyone going toward Tiger this evening? Jay needs a ride home.
Ride home.
Talk to him when he gets off the chair.
Yeah.
So you don't have to come up now. We don't need to know where you live. But later, Jay needs a ride to southeast Beaverton. All right.
Apparently, I found out my last bus was at 15 minutes ago.
How are you the newest member of the open source community? Did you join like 5 minutes ago?
Apparently, the company I work for just sponsored the event this evening, and I happened to attend.
What company?
It's WebTrends.
Ah, you're... Look, I can see your offices.
It's...
You guys have the lights on. Not conserving energy over there, are you?
Apparently not.
We should have a word with someone about that.
Yeah, well...
Who at WebTrends
sure
would we have a word with?
What, honey?
Who at WebTrends would we have a word with if we wanted to, say, talk about the lights? We'll work on that.
Mirrorblog.com.
Oh, I know all about Mirrorblog. Well, is Justin still here? Did he head home yet?
I'm not sure.
Yeah. He's got his little mustache thing. So,
Jay, tell us about you.
So,
I feel like you have a story. He came sitting down all full of energy.
Several stories.
All right. Let's hear one.
Well, before I want to know what he likes to drink.
Yeah. Black Butte Porter is one of my biggest favorites.
Black Butte Porter.
Porter's darkest beer is the favorite. Dark beers, right. Mm-hmm. It's one of my favorites. So my story is I grew up in Salt Lake and mm-hmm. joined the Navy. Through the Navy, ended up in Seattle, and then down to Portland after the fact. And
mm-hmm. I like Seattle.
Seattle.
I like Portland.
Fair.
Portland's better than Seattle, if you ask me.
You hear that? Portland's better.
I heard your show, so I'm not gonna.
My auntie.
So what you working on?
I have a better question than what he's working on. He's been stalked by a hotel cat.
I have been stalked by a hotel cat in this building. Apparently,
in this building.
Hotel cat apparently resided in this building mm-hmm. for the past 3 months.
Mm-hmm.
The hotel room he resided in was across from where I currently am mm-hmm. in my office.
Mm-hmm.
He, for whatever reason, he decided to stare at me every day.
I have a crow that lives outside my house, and it follows me down the street, and it doesn't make a noise. But when animals come out of other places, it swoops down and caws at them and makes these awful noises.
Yeah.
Really?
Well, this cat apparently...
Really?
He sits in his
Really?
I can't hear what Alex said because he said... My protector. I think it is my protector.
I feel like Dr. Normal wants to weigh in on this.
I just wanted to say, so what you working on?
Okay.
Oh, we got it. Oh, hey. You know what I think, Cami? I have a proposal.
You do?
I do. I think we have a number of guests to get through, and we have a little bit of time left. I don't want to cut Jay short, but
I want Jay to tell us what he's working on, and then...
Maybe we should do speed round.
Oh, my God, really?
Ooh.
Yeah.
Okay.
And we could set a clock after Jay, right? We could set a timer, and we could do 2 minutes, and you're next.
No, we'll start. We'll start. We'll give Jay 3 more minutes.
Okay.
And then we'll do the same thing with it, because that's what I did. Did you see the bar camp episode?
Yeah.
Okay. So I think it's a good idea, because I just realized that we're...
Well, hold on. We got to get the timer ready, Dr. Normal.
All right, what are you working on? Go.
Okay.
Go.
What am I doing?
What are you working on?
So, currently I'm working on... basically working on some tools to work on our current company's analytics tools to...
Web Trends analytics tools?
Yes.
Okay.
As tools to better our clients' activity to their data, to give bigger access to our data and...
So how are you the newest member of the open source community? Because Web Trends just joined in with it?
No. It's personally me
uh-huh.
that I haven't had any access to the open source community till I was introduced to it tonight.
So you haven't used any of the open source tools?
No, I have not.
Have you ever used WordPress?
I'm sorry?
WordPress?
No, sure I haven't.
Ooh, Linux?
I've used Linux a few times in the past, but
that is open source.
That is open source.
Linux
correct.
Is open source.
I have installed Linux on a few computers I have at home.
Mm-hmm.
But actually openly embraced it beyond the fact of installing it and using, you know, some of the desktop software and other stuff like that. I haven't actually done anything beyond that.
Yeah. And now that you've been exposed and embraced by it, what do you think?
I definitely think it has great opportunities. There's definitely no limitations onto where it can go.
Mm-hmm.
There's no limitations I can see. So I just need to get in there. And embrace it.
Just kind of dirty up your hands and dive right in?
Dive right in, get into some applications, develop some applications, get some stuff built,
mm-hmm.
deployed, distributed, so on and so forth.
And you had one place to start. Where would it be?
I would guess it would be one place to start with was some activity into the web.
Mm-hmm.
The web website design.
Mm-hmm.
And particular into the standards, the standards,
mm-hmm.
which seems to be the focus nowadays, where
where websites need to you know, divert from the flash and the other kind of you know, third-party utilities to where it's going back to the standards of XHTML and CSS,
mm-hmm.
and using Ajax and other kind of standards utilities to develop the website beyond using plugins, using more of the standards.
So back to standards, less of the add-ons.
Yeah.
And before you go, can you tell everyone where they can find you on Twitter?
Twitter account is JRaz.
And where can they find you on the web?
That's pretty much it.
All right. There you go. Oh, timer is up. Thank you so much, Jay. It was good to meet you.
All right.
Thank you, Jay. Yep.
Don't forget to sign the guest board on your way.
We have a guest board right here for you, Jay. Jay, right there.
Oh, right there.
Yeah. All right. Don't forget to sign that.
Ah, I saw you down at the square. I have your button on my shirt that I'm no longer wearing. Yeah, that
you're no longer wearing because I'm very curious about the dress, actually.
Hold on.
It's sexy, and where did you get it? Not that I can pull it off, but
I have asked that question
awesome.
So many times this evening.
Yeah.
It makes me know that I bought the right dress.
You did.
There is a consignment shop down the street from my house called The Silver Lining that I absolutely love.
Okay.
And I shop there a lot, and I got it there.
That's
so
amazing.
It was the only one there, and I have no idea where it actually came from because I bought it secondhand.
Wow, I'm speechless because everybody else is in this room as well.
but at least you bought it, right? It wasn't one of those like, oh, maybe I should get it, and then
no,
you left it there and then come back to it.
No, yeah. I went in and I was there with a friend and I tried it on and I came out and the gal who was working at the store and my uh-huh. friend were both like, take that home.
Yeah, exactly.
So, all right. Yeah. Now we need to stop and introduce
enough,
you. Hurricane McEwen.
Yes.
At Hurricane McEwen on Twitter?
That's correct.
Where are you on the web?
HurricaneMcEwen.com as well.
All right, you have 4 minutes and 9 seconds to tell us about OpenStreetMap.
OpenStreetMap is a community of people building the free map of the world. Mm-hmm. There are over 120,000 members worldwide.
120,000?
Yes.
Okay.
It's a young project. It's about 4 years old. Started by a brilliant young man named Steve Coast out of England mm-hmm. because map data in England and Europe is not free. I know, crazy, right?
So not like in the States, you Google Maps, you get anything
but
you want.
Right.
Is it actually free in the States? Because
no, it's free as in beer here, but not free as in speech.
So it can be
free
licensed.
Free as in beer, but not free as in speech.
Ah, yeah, mold that over for a while, right? So free as in speech allows us to be able to use this data, to manipulate this data, to add to it, to subtract to it, to make it what we need it to be. And work from there. And that's the power of OpenStreetMap. So beyond Google Maps, which we all love, I do as well.
Sure.
OpenStreetMap adds in hiking trails. It adds in ski trails. It adds in hiking trails. It adds manholes. It adds in curbs of sidewalks. It adds in any richness to the database you want to.
Everything that's out there, you can find it.
Yeah, for example, you might think that the database of sidewalks is kind of crazy, right?
Mm-hmm.
Try and hop over a sidewalk with a mountain bike or a wheelchair.
Or, right.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You want this data to be able to route, to be able to get places. So this database is very rich in being able to navigate, to do many things with.
Mm-hmm.
Not to mention just simply walking directions, right? I mean,
exactly.
Yeah, because
exactly.
The other maps that are out there on the internet right now mainly focus on getting around by car, by bus, by train.
Exactly. And even then, you sort of wonder, is the one-way routing correct?
Mm-hmm.
Because things change. They're volatile, right? They change all the time, whether we build new neighborhoods, whether we build new government buildings, whether we change the block next door. Mm-hmm. And the power of OpenStreetMap is because you and I can edit it.
So
it's correct.
It's open.
If you don't like it, change it.
Exactly. Everyone can get
open.
Their hands in.
Exactly. And for example, I live in a really small town in Colorado, actually, and we have one stoplight. And
what
we used to have a Harley Davidson dealership
mm-hmm.
right on the corner. Well, it's no longer there. What is it now? It's U-Haul.
Mm-hmm.
And I was able just to go in, change the details. If there's one-way routing, you can change those details as well. It's very, very, very applicable.
So you're not just mapping the infrastructure, you're also mapping the businesses that are in those buildings? Is that
exactly.
Right?
Okay. And the capability of this map is it's much more than just streets. So, for example, you go down, you map all your local Walmarts. You map. Well, I know.
For instance.
For instance. Okay, let's make this more interesting. You can map your local pubs.
There you go.
Oh,
map
the local pubs.
Maybe map.
Yes, exactly. You map your pub crawl. Mm-hmm. So you have pubs. You have ATMs. Yep, exactly.
Absolutely. I think it's a great idea. Well, and more strip clubs per capita in Gresham than anywhere else.
There you go. Map those out. Parking garages. I mean, anything that you find unique to yourself.
I'm going to interrupt you for a moment because we've only got about half a minute left.
Okay.
I want to know about the mapping party, and I want to know where we can find OpenStreetMap online.
This would be awesome. So as a community, we're in town this weekend. We have a mapping party at the downtown library tomorrow from 11.
The downtown library.
Downtown library from 11 to 4 tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
And then on Sunday, we have a great hiking trip from 9 a.m. to 2 mm-hmm. on Sunday at Forest Park.
Forest Park.
Yeah, and go to openstreetmap.org to find out all the details.
Okay.
And it's come and go as you will, and we would love to have people there to learn about the community.
Openstreetmap.org.
Correct.
All right,
and
cool.
Hurricane McEwen on Twitter.
Yep.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
thank you. Now it makes noise.
Thank you. Don't forget to sign the board with her.
I've been hoping you would come on. We have Christy Kohler and Sherry Montgomery, and I'll let you guys share your Twitter. Oh, you're Yogini! Oh! Hi!
Yeah, I'm PDX Yogini.
Okay, so share your Twitter names, not that I didn't just squeal one.
All right. I'm Christy. It's actually Kaler on Twitter.
Oh, Kaler, I'm sorry.
And that's C-H-R-I-S-T-I-E-K-O-E-H-L-E-R. There'll be a quiz on that later.
On the pronunciation, which I got wrong, or the spelling, which I got right?
Both.
And I'm PDX Yogini, which is Y-O-G-I-N-I.
PDX.
Yogini.
Yeah.
Which means someone who does yoga.
And you were the volunteer coordinator for OS Bridge.
I was.
And you rocked.
Thank you. You know what, though?
I forgot to... I'm almost at the time, but you go. I'm going to give you guys 2 extra minutes.
All right. Okay. I really couldn't have rocked without a really rockin' army of wonderful, extraordinary volunteers.
Yeah.
So they deserve a round of applause as well.
Volunteers? Yay! Did any of you volunteer? Because give yourself a round of applause, too.
Yeah. And really, the list of names was too long for me to bring on. But it was amazing job by the volunteers. So.
I saw an amazing, it was like an army of the little purple ribbons with the volunteers. It was purple, right?
Yeah.
With the little purple volunteer ribbon. Yeah. I was amazed every time I saw one. I was like,
yeah, it was wonderful.
There's so many
of
you. So how did it go from, oh my God, we have this great idea. We're going to have an open source conference in Portland because we don't have one anymore, to this. Not to this, but to that, and then this.
Well, I came in towards the end of the process when I had wanted to participate earlier but had been really busy, and I knew that Audrey and Selena and everyone was working really hard. And during bar camp, I was talking to Audrey. I said, I've got some time coming up. What do you need done? And she's like, well, we really need a volunteer coordinator.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, oh, I'll do it. And then it was just a matter of at least that part of it. We had a couple of recruiting meetings ahead of time. Web Trends hosted one, and then we kind of just spread the word on Twitter, and it worked out that we were able to offer free admission to anyone who volunteered 8 hours. So that was a really great way to bring in people who maybe wouldn't have been able to come otherwise, but wanted to contribute. So,
how many volunteers, not the volunteers that help everything get ready in advance, but how many volunteers that were there helping on the ground with their feet running around at the conference did you have?
I haven't added it up yet, but it was at least 40. It was sort of in that range.
And what kind of stuff were they doing?
All kinds of stuff. We had people in the sessions monitoring to making sure nothing went wrong. Counting how many people were there, manning the info desk, helping out the speakers get what they needed. Helping registration, greeting people at the door. Yeah.
Pretty much everything because it was a volunteer-run conference.
Exactly, yeah.
Which I keep saying and I keep thinking about, but I, I keep having a hard time wrapping my brain around the fact that everyone that was there was volunteering their time.
Yeah, it was pretty, very, very amazing. And it was such really positive energy. I mean, I had volunteers stay past their shifts and come check with me. Is there anything else that you need? It was really wonderful. So
when you're not coordinating the volunteers and volunteering at OS Bridge, what are you doing?
I run a small web development shop. Mm-hmm. By small, I mean me. And I'm also a Zen Buddhist practitioner with a local group here in town. And I co-run Code Insplode, mm-hmm, with Gabrielle Roth. And Code Insplode is a group for women and open source. And I think, did I miss anything?
I don't know, but do you think that Portland has a larger than usual female contingent of open source advocates, users, developers, etc.?
I think so. It's sort of hard to tell. I moved from San Francisco about a year and a half ago, mm-hmm, and it was really hard for me to engage with the community there.
Yeah.
But actually, I went to a Code Insplode meeting almost immediately upon moving here, and I was just immediately sucked in. And I felt really supported and engaged, and it sort of, you know, led to me doing two talks at the conference in addition to the volunteer coordinating. So I don't have exact numbers, but that's just my personal experience with it.
It seems to me like it's larger. When I hear the percentages and I look at Portland, I'm kind of like, wow, Portland's really skewed.
I think it is, yeah.
So. All right, Sherry?
Yes.
How are you?
I'm okay.
Is that a Manhattan that you're drinking?
That is a Manhattan I have.
I'm good at identifying beverages by looking at them.
I didn't fill up for a martini, but decided to go with the same glass shape.
I'm a martini kind of girl. Were you at OS Bridge?
I was.
And what were you doing?
I was doing everything that Christy needed to do that she didn't already have a volunteer for, including feeding her.
Yeah. That is really important.
So, yeah, I took on us to make sure that the volunteer coordinator didn't collapse yet.
From experience at conferences, the most difficult part of the conference is actually getting food in you that doesn't make you want to fall asleep.
And we're both vegans, so yeah. There was some planning involved to make sure.
I do remember my favorite Christy quote was the day before the conference started, and it was, "The bagels aren't even vegan, so I don't trust anything."
Yeah. I spent Tuesday evening when Rasmus was doing his thing, making a great deal of food and bringing it each morning. I would wake up and say, I'd IM her and say, "Okay, what did you forget?" and bring all of that to the... And then I did a session, too. And
what was your session?
It was Get Off Your Asana and Move, which was a yoga for programmers and geeks.
And she
made
nerds touch each other.
I got them to do partner yoga, which I don't think anyone saw coming. And someone did try to get out of it by saying, "Oh, I don't have a partner." And I'm like, "Oh, yeah, you do. I'm your partner." So, yeah. And it was a lot of fun.
So is partnered yoga more difficult for people to digest than doing yoga on your own?
Yeah, absolutely. People don't like to touch each other.
No.
Especially when they're like, you know, feel like they're being kind of vulnerable in doing yoga and, oh, this might hurt. And, oh, God, now you want someone to touch me? Yeah. But it's a lot of fun, actually, to do yoga with someone, to do a partnered thing.
Didn't you also have a yoga session at... bar camp?
Yes, yeah. And at bar camp, I came and brought mats, and we did full sun salutations in this little tiny room, and I'm surprised no one hit one another, and we had injuries. It was a lot of fun.
How do you find the geeks? So the people that come in during the conferences to come do yoga with you, are they people who are used to it, or are they newcomers?
Both.
Both.
There's several people that come that are people who have yoga practices here, mm-hmm, and they, you know, they already kind of know and they're looking forward to it. Mm-hmm. And then there's a lot of people who were brand new and thought it just sounded interesting and decided to come check it out. And I thought I was really actually surprised and how many people came. It was a lot of fun, and we ended up going out in the hall and just taking over the lobby because there's no one else around.
Did you have an open source aspect to it? Was there like an angle on it, or?
You know, no one actually took me up on asking about that because I tweeted about it saying, you know, I would be willing to geek out on anyone because yoga is this thing that's been taught for thousands of years and is really in the past 100 years or so has been made very open and accessible, and now is being threatened with, you know, people wanting to copyright stuff Yeah, and
how can you copyright yoga?
Exactly. And India is starting to step and go step up and say, this is our cultural heritage. You're not allowed to copyright it.
Yeah.
And it reminds me a lot of some of the stuff that's happened in open source that, technology comes up and then companies come in and they want to say, oh, this is proprietary, and no, it's this knowledge that's shared and passed down and only strengthened by being shared.
Mm-hmm. So they actually have an interesting link between them.
To me, they do.
Yeah.
And maybe it's because I do both so much, but they've got a link.
Do you find, and this is the one thing that I found most, because I'm not so much with the coding, I can't, I can understand what's going on, but I can't really do it myself. But I find that with open source practitioners and other parts of the community, there's really usually a big tie between people and the way that they live their lives. Do you see that as... We'll just tell the timer to be quiet for a moment. But do you see that as well? I mean, there's like the bicyclists, there's health movements, there's different ways that people eat and different ways that people embrace each other. Do you see a link between open source technology and an open source community?
I think especially it incorporates that idea of sharing and being a community and developing things together. And I think when people develop things together, where they're software or they're, building in a community garden, mm-hmm. they're just strengthening their ties as a community and learning how to work together and share knowledge collaboratively instead of just kind of hoarding it away and not strengthening the community by it. So they I think they teach each other a lot. And I think in Portland's open source community, you see people who are involved not just in open source community, but they're deeply involved in the Portland community as well and volunteering their time in all kinds of ways. So I think they lean on each other.
Very cool. We've got to run. I've got to bring my co-host back up. But can you tell everyone once again where to find both of you on Twitter?
I'm PDX Yogini on Twitter.
And Christy Kaler.
O-E.
Yes.
That's what I have to tell you. I'm sorry. I said your name wrong. And where can we find you online?
ChristyKaler.com. Sort of portal.
And samathayoga.com.
Can you spell it?
S-A-M-A-T-H-A, which means calm abiding in Sanskrit.
Calm abiding?
Calm abiding or tranquility.
All right, very nice. Can you guys both go ahead and sign the guest board? And thank you so much for joining
Thanks.
Us.
Thanks. Thank you.
Brian, we went a little bit over our timeline.
Oh, dear.
I mean, we started late, but we still went a little over our timeline.
But it was fun.
I had a good time.
It was a good time. It was
Twitter?
A really good time. Great show. Twitter. Oh, wait.
Oh,
Twitter.
It's empty.
And mine's over there, as it were.
My drink is empty. Yours is gone. I think it might be time to end the show.
You know, when our beverages are empty.
Again.
That might be the cue.
Dr. Normal, do you have anything to tell the ladies and
Dr.
gentlemen?
Dr. Normal.
Yeah. I want to say a couple things. First of all, for StrangeLove Live, Nate De Niro and
Nate
Kelly
DiNelli.
At Verso.
Verso.
Huge thanks to you guys.
I don't think
for
huge quite sums up the amount of thanks we need to give them.
What I love about especially the two of those.
Oh, what Dr. Normal was saying is, oh my God, thank you so much, Uncle Nate and Verso. We could not have done all of these on-location shows without the two of you.
I actually think, and I've told them both this separately, that each of them just sort of picked up the slack and, like, everything. The camera and this and that and the other. Amazing. Awesome job.
And Christine Kistner.
Christine,
well.
Yeah.
Probably gone home by now.
Yes, yeah. Did graphics and B-roll.
A lot of B-roll.
As well.
A lot of shooting, yeah.
So thank you, Email Steen, Verso, and Uncle Nate. We could not have done this
Yay.
Without you. We're so grateful.
Thanks,
and
Brian,
thank you
for being here.
And thank you to Brian for being my beautiful, lovely co-host this evening.
But thank you to Cami Kaos and Dr. Normal for bringing this show to the Portland tech community. I think it's awesome. Everybody loves StrangeLove Live. Let's give StrangeLove Live a big applause. And Cami Kaos, I would like to say a big thank you to everyone that went to Open Source Bridge this week.
I
and
concur.
To everyone in the Hacker Lounge right now. You guys are awesome. Give yourselves a big round of applause.
Did he mumble something? Or
I don't know.
Was it important? If it was important, please repeat it. Nate, was that important? Please repeat it if it was important.
Well, I was just saying I paid.
Oh, you paid to come to the Hacker Lounge? Okay, Nate paid to go to Open Source Bridge. So let's give a big, amazingly huge round of applause to everyone who paid to go to Open Source Bridge.
And to the Open Source Bridge sponsors that made it happen, and to the tireless volunteers we can't
thank them
enough.
You know what? I know what we should do. We should give huge rounds of applause to everyone.
To everyone.
To everybody.
To everyone.
Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. Next week, we're going to be celebrating, and it seems like we're always celebrating something, but next week, we're going to be celebrating the one-year anniversary of our PDX. But we will be back in our home studio for that, and I hope you join us online. Thank you so much, everyone. Good night.
Good night.